And we're live. It's only been a week, I keep reminding myself, since I last sat here in this little corner of my apartment. And it feels like I haven't done one of these shows in a really long time. And I'm suddenly remembering the first time I did it where I was like, how does the internet work? I wonder if my lighting is the way I want it. Let's see. Anyway, this is Rebecca Hart, Songs from the Chrysalis, number 15. I know that at 4:00, this is the point where everybody is like, I hope, getting their snacks and their cup of tea and all that. So I'm just gonna give it a second and have my cup of tea from this mug that has my niece's self-portrait on it. Pretty awesome. Do you have your picture on a mug? So welcome to Songs from the Chrysalis, number 15. The ghost story edition, for several reasons, which I will go into, but you know, I might as well just warm up here, so I'm gonna play some stuff. I feel like I'm at a weirder angle than usual. David Ross, hello. Yes, snack time for everybody. This is like sound check, and you guys are just hanging out in the venue with me. How long my hair is getting. You guys, I went to the beach. I bought a hat. It was a really exciting week. I almost wore the hat, but I didn't. Maybe it's obvious. Maybe it comes to some of us. Maybe the rest is just dust. It's dust. It's dust. It's dust. It's dust. It's dust. Well, I got a pencil and a broom. And I could go sweep out my front room, or just write, help, send a hot air balloon in the dust, and dust, it's dust, it's dust, it's dust. Haven't we met somewhere before? Haven't we met somewhere before? What country, friends, is this? And if you say Illyria, lady, I got a bridge to sell you and a port. I got a church and a steeple, but no people, and I think the king has probably by now left the court. I got a bag of tricks that are all left untreated. You're only as sick as your secrets. You're coming up short. Two singer-songwriters go into a bar and say, well, this must be middle age. I recognized it by the lust and rage, but mostly lust. What do you mean, hot flashes? No, I mean ashes. I'm talking about ashes to ashes. It's dust and dust and dust and dust. It's dust. It's dust. It's dust. It's dust. It's dust. Haven't we met somewhere before? Haven't we met somewhere before? Giant band jam that ends like this. All right, you guys. How is your 4th of July? What a strange year for the birth of our nation. And on that topic, hello, hello, Megan. Yay, hi, John. New people, welcome. This is Songs from the Chrysalis. My name is Rebecca Hart. I am here every Sunday, except last Sunday where I was at the beach. Still there, water's still there. Very exciting. Yeah, this is my 4th of July song this year, and it goes like this. Oh wait, I didn't, turning up the guitar. It's always good to turn on the volume. I have to tell you, I woke up at 5 this morning because there was a gentleman in the street having a very loud argument with an unseen enemy, and it went on for a very long time, and finally I was like, I guess we're getting up. It's like having a rooster. And then at like 11 a.m. he started doing it again, and I was like, aren't you tired? I'm tired just thinking about singing my set. Anyway, here we go. That's a little loud. Anyway. 3. I heard about you when you fall, that's when it's scary, but you're looking fine, let's have a ball. I'm thinking of myself, I mean about my health, I welcome one and all to the disaster in the oh, oh, leave your disaster in the oh, oh, 1, 2, 3. Oh, oh, blue canary, what an attractive little bird, but you seem so wary. What have I done? What have you heard? That I fiddle while rum burns? Judge a man by what he earns? Rob Peter to pay Paul for the disaster in the... Oh, 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 the disaster in the... in the home. Oh, I know my words look strange sometimes. Well, that's why other people write my rhymes. I have the best people, the best people. Been my special girl, sweet, sedentary, but now you're screaming bloody murder, murder keep it down, I got my name all over town, got my image to preserve, you know I'm always thinking, thinking about myself, I mean about my wealth, I mean about your health, look I gotta take this call, leave your disaster in the hall, leave the disaster in the disaster in the hall. All right, that's very cathartic to me. I'm still working on like the perfect angle for this show, and right now I can see my head and then all of your comments. I'm like made out of internet comments. It's a very weird and appropriate kind of image. And also for this set, which is the ghosts and haunting set, I sort of look like, hi Greg, thank you for your little hand claps. Hi Guy. And Bixby, this is a very exciting set. I'm not going to talk yet. I'm just going to play some more stuff. I wanted to say this was the whole point of the ghost set. It was inspired by the fact that a podcast called The Muse Podcast launched last week and is about new musicals and has features writing teams talking and singing through their whole show. And one of those teams was me and my partner, Jacynth Greywood, talking about and singing through our musical, Iron John, an American Ghost Story. And I'm assuming, since I didn't play last week, that all of you guys listened to it. But in case you didn't, it's great for a long car ride or, you know, just hanging out in quarantine. If we're still doing that, what are we doing? It came out okay, and I hate listening to the sound of my own voice, ironically. Just pitching that. This is a song from my album, The Magician's Daughter, which is about death, so I guess it counts, but specifically about changing matter, changing shape and form, and what is eternal even though it changes. You gave yourself a good dream. That something could be said. Turn yourself inside out and wrestled with your head. Should there be a taxi waiting at your door? Well, don't hesitate to spend my love. What's living for? Didn't I see you move the goalposts, gather your roses and your wrongs? Why did you feed me such a low dose? Why did it take so long? Gave your girl a diamond. You made it out of dust. She would not leave the island, no. And knowing that we must, you are become a sailor, calling out her name. Yeah. Love, and that's a living shame. Didn't I see you move the goalposts, Why did it take so long? Thank you. Hi, Marta. Oh, I love that I am being listened to on the Hamptons jitney. That makes me feel extremely fabulous. Thanks, Guy. Hi, Phil. Hi, JJ. Not so much like a ghost, but just wait. I originally conceived the theme for this week based on Iron John, An American Ghost Story. Go listen to the podcast. I will post it. It is posted on my Facebook page and at Iron John Musical. That's our Instagram, because the kids that we did the show with made one. And I got really excited about that. I was like, ooh, I'm gonna sing songs about hauntings and ghost stories and murder ballads and stuff. And I actually think it's appropriate for the season because we just passed the summer solstice. And what I love about the solstices is that they're the opposite of themselves. Like the winter solstice is cold and dark and a short, shortest day. But it's also where the light half of the year begins. Even if you can't feel it, the light starts to grow and the days get longer. And the summer solstice is the opposite of itself, where actually everything starts to get shorter, even though it feels hot outside, the darkness is coming back, which is, you know, my jam. So I was all ready to do this. Hi, Chris. I was all ready to do this. And then I was also like, and also Monday is my birthday. So now it's my birthday show. My birthday is tomorrow. Now that has to be part of the theme also. I can't like get away with more than once. So I'm giving myself a birthday present this week of just doing some new stuff, doing whatever I'd like to do. And one of the things, you guys, I don't know if you've heard about this, but the theater industry is kind of on hold right now. And that is what I do or did a lot of before I was in my apartment playing for you and playing with my band. And I really miss it. And I was thinking, because I got this beautiful tribute from a poet friend of mine this week. She wrote some really nice stuff about my album online, and it took me back to the days when I first came to New York and first started playing out. And the first audience that I had, thank you for my happy pre-birthday. The first audience that I had was the poets and the slam poets and the spoken word, Poken's word, that is what I almost said. You guys, I'm tired. Who kind of adopted me, and I would play songs in a poetry night when everybody else was speaking and reading poems. And I used to say I'm a sung word artist because I thought that was hilarious. So this week I was like, you know what, I was gonna read one of this poet's poems, but she wants me to wait so she can pick the right one for me to do. So I have a couple of what should we call it, sung talking things that I want to do. And one of them is Puck's speech from Midsummer Night's Dream, which, hold on, not the one that everybody does. If you listen to it, like Midsummer Night's Dream is like fairies and love affairs and everybody gets married in the end and it's really happy. And then Puck comes out at the end and does this thing that's like, this show is not for children. Or it is, but it's like, just want to remind you that there's really scary things out there and the nighttime is a scary place. And then right at the end, he saves it by being like, but don't you guys worry, because I'm here to guard the house. And I've always really loved it. And I think I didn't read it on actual Midsummer, so I'm going to read it today. So just pretend you guys are like 8 years old and we're around a campfire and someone says, now the hungry lion roars and the wolf behowls the moon, whilst the heavy plowman snores, all with weary task foredone. Now the wasted brands do glow, whilst the screech owl, screeching loud, puts the wretch that lies in woe in remembrance of a shroud. Now it is the time of night that the graves, all gaping wide, every one lets forth its sprite in the churchway paths to glide. And we fairies that do run by the triple Hecate's team from the presence of the sun, following darkness like a dream, now are frolic. Not a mouse will disturb this hallowed house. I am sent with broom before to sweep the dust behind the door. Or your artificial light. I'll take it all, it takes all night. My guest of honor knows how to hide. I look okay from the outside. Devil knows no bounds, and he knows, la-da-dum, you're here. He knows. There was no open window. There might have been a door. Maybe these tracks across the floor. To begin, he always gets invited in. And you can't save me with the garden wall. Do the best you do. Be afraid, my devil knows no bounds. And he goes, la da dum, right through. He goes. Solo. I have to play it. I'm doing it in my head. I know Matt's watching. You can't save me with the words you know. Oh, you can't run me clear. I'm afraid my devil knows no bounds. La-da-dum, you're here. He knows. La-da-dum, you're here. He knows. La-da-dum. Whew. All right, I just played that with the chorus effect on it, which is not right for that song, but I, you know, didn't want to stop, and the show must go on. So, hi, you guys. I hope you had some kind of 4th of July yesterday. Watched the Hamilton finally. I saw it on my birthday actually a few years ago. This may be the last week that I turn off the air conditioning for this show, but it does make the sound better. Chris, I hope I get to play Puck one day too. I almost did when I had very short hair because, you know, people have the same idea over and over again. But I went on to play Hermia and Snout in the same production and it was really fun. So I was looking at ghost songs and haunt songs of haunting, and I realized that there really would not be a way to do a folk show dedicated to this subject and leave out the song She Moved Through the Fair, which is a traditional song, about, like so many of them are, about a young couple who were going to be wed and tragedy intervenes, and it's very sad. It's a very subtle ghost story, so see if you can feel where the turn is. And also, I think this is from the air conditioning. I am not sick. I am totally fine. but I sound like I'm 80 years old, which is not the age I am turning tomorrow. In case you needed to know that. Anyway, She Moved Through the Fair is a song that many, many folk artists have done. And there is like 200 verses and many alternate lyrics. I am only going to do the one that I know. So it goes like this. Actually, maybe we'll have the guitar just for fun, in case. My love said to me, my mother won't mind, and my father won't slight you for your lack of kind. Then she stepped away from me, and this she did say, it will not be long, my love, till our wedding day. She stepped away from me, and she moved through the fair, and fondly I watched her move here and move there. I went my way homeward with one star awake, as the swans in the evening moved over the lake. People were saying no two e'er were wed, but one has a sorrow that never is said. She walked her way home with all her goods and her gear, and that was the last that I saw of my dear. I dreamt it last night that my true love came in. So softly she entered, her feet made no din. She came close beside me, and this she did say, till our wedding day. She's a ghost. Did you get that part? I feel like some versions say, my dead love came in, and I'm like, why would you give it all away? That's no fair. All right, so moving forward into more of the covers. This is a dark, dark song in the murder ballad tradition, which was my introduction to Gillian Welch, who is an amazing modern contemporary folk artist, if you don't know her. She is from basically now, I think she's from Massachusetts. She sounds like an old woman sitting on her porch in Virginia 100 years ago, which is part of why I love her. And this is a song that, like all murder ballads, involves a violent crime and a person, usually a woman, dying violently at the hands of usually a man. But this one has a little bit of a twist, and it goes to a place that you don't expect. And I'm just going to be kind of a little dark and dedicate this week to Vanessa Gwillen, or Gillen, I don't know how to say her name, who is of course the army officer, soldier, who died on April 20th after complaining about being sexually harassed and bothered by another sergeant. The complaints were ignored. And then she was murdered and chopped up and her body was found, but I'm sure those two things aren't related at all. And anyway, I hope she comes back and haunts the shit out of everyone involved. So I wrote down the lyrics for myself in my terrible handwriting, so we'll just see if they even help. But I listened to this a lot at one point, so we should be fine. Anyway, Caleb Meyer goes like this. Thank you. you call my name. And made a little whiskey for himself, set it out past the time. One evening in the back of my house, Caleb come around, and he called my name till I came out with no one else around. Caleb Meyer, your ghost is gone to wear them rattling chains, but when I go to sleep at night, don't you call my name. Did he go all down the mountainside and leave you all alone? Ladies, this is where you say, no, he's here, and he has a weapon. But it's a murder ballad. Yes, my husband's gone to Bowling Green to do some business there. Then Caleb threw that bottle down and grabbed me by my hair. Caleb Meyer, your ghost is gone to wear them rattling chains. But when I go to sleep at night, don't you call my name. Then he held my hands above my head, and I began to pray. I cried, my God, I am your child, send your angels down. And then feeling with my fingertips the bottleneck I found, I drew that glass across his neck, fine as any blade. And I felt his blood pour fast and hot around me where I lay. Caleb Meyer, your ghost is gone to wear them rattling chains. But when I go to sleep at night, don't you call my name. Caleb Meyer, your ghost is gone to wear them rattling chains. But when I go to sleep at night, don't you call my name.
Badass. I also like how she sets up the storytelling. She tells you he's dead, and then she tells you more of the story, and then she's like, but he's dead. Woo, I fucking love that song. Excuse my language. So moving on to another song that felt like, this is not a ghost song, but it felt like, oh, duh, how could I not be playing this song at this time in our nation's history? So we'll just call it a 4th of July song in a way. Let's see. this is a Sinead O'Connor song that was covered recently by an artist called Shea Rose, and I'll post her version later. And I'm just gonna look at these chords again because I can't remember them. I'll be fine. So she wrote this actually about two different people. In 1983, a young black man named Colin Roach was shot by police in a doorway. It was covered up and ruled a suicide, even though it was very, very obviously not a suicide, at least according to what I have read. There had been complaints in the neighborhood from the community about police brutality. They were ignored, just like Vanessa Gulen's complaints. And Sinead O'Connor dedicated this song and her whole album to him and his family. But she also references a young man named Nicholas Bramble, also a 21-year-old black man who was killed in a high-speed chase with police on his own moped because they thought it was stolen. And let's see if I can read my own writing again. Feel free to sing along. This is a sing-along. Margaret Thatcher on TV, shocked by the deaths that took place in Beijing. Seems strange that she should be offended. The same orders were given by her. Well, I've said this before now. You said I was childish, then you say it now. Remember what I told you. If they hated me, they will hate you. I remember I sang, not that, but at my sister's wedding, I sang a song, and it was a very emotional occasion, and I started crying two lines into it, which, in retrospect, everyone should have expected, and I not only started crying during the song, I went, "I told you this would happen," into the microphone in front of the entire wedding. It was really embarrassing. So this takes me back. So anyway, just as a little palate cleanser, I'm going to play one of my songs. Thank you for being here, you guys. Hi, Arlene. Hi, everybody. My name is Rebecca Hart, by the way. This is a song series called Songs from the Chrysalis. It is number 15. You can sign up to get love notes from me and reminders about this at RebeccaHart.net. And I also have a tip jar, which is at Venmo, Rebecca-Hart-5, or PayPal at Rebecca@RebeccaHart.net. I think that's up on this screen somewhere. Yeah, and also listen to the Iron John podcast if you know what's good for you. This is a little song I wrote about hope. I dream of waking up to find that nothing's broken. It's not my fault, and I found my mind, and it was just where I was hoping. I dream of laughing with the friends who said no better, and I don't need to change my mind, or them, or you, and all the doors are opening.
Yeah, all the doors are open.
right, you guys, are you having snacks? The people who aren't on the Hampton Jitney. I know if you're on the Hampton Jitney, you're having snacks. That's a good bus. Speaking of scary things, P.S., right before I played this show, I got my COVID test a couple days ago, which, like, why not? Very easy, very fast, very weird. They put a Q-tip into your brain. And it's been like 3 days, even though I knew it wasn't ready. I was like, I wonder how you find out your results. And I went onto the site and logged into my little patient thing. And I looked down, and in the results area, it says, positive, colon, you have COVID. And then starts to explain all of the things. And I was like, no one wanted to call me about this, you know? And I'm completely losing my mind. And then I see, negative, colon, you do not have COVID. And I was like, cool, thanks. Thanks for explaining to us in this area what positive and negative mean. So that was my birthday heart attack. Thank you so much. Anyway, speaking of, I can do whatever I want because it's my birthday tomorrow. I'm gonna read another poem. And some of you who know me might know that I pull this poem out all the time. I really love it. It's by a man named Wesley McNair, who I know nothing about besides the fact that he wrote this poem. But I think it's a good kind of poem if you're about to turn another year and like are starting to have some thoughts about life and resentments and whatnot and trying to remember what it means to surrender and to accept things. Anyway, I love this poem. Stay with me. It's not that long. It's called The Rules of the New Car, much like the honking that's going on in the street right now. The Rules of the New Car. After I got married and became the stepfather of two children, just before we had two more, I bought it. The bright blue, sorrowful car that slowly turned to scratches and the flat black spots of gum in the seats and stains impossible to remove from the floor mats. Never again, I said, as our kids, four of them by now, climbed into the new car. This time, there will be rules. The first to go was the rule I made for myself about cleaning it once a week, though why, I shouted at the kids in the rearview mirror, should I have to clean it if they would just remember to fold their hands? 3 years later, it was the same car I had before, except for the dent my wife put in the grill when, ignoring the regulation about snacks, she reached for a bag of chips on her way home from work and hit a tow truck. Oh, the ache I felt for the broken rules, and the beautiful car that had been lost, and the car that we now had on soft shocks in the driveway, still unpaid for. Then one day, for no particular reason except that the car was loaded down with wood for the fireplace at my in-laws' camp, and groceries and sheets and clothes for the week, my wife in the passenger seat, the dog lightly panting beside the kids in the back, all innocent anticipation, waiting for me to join them, I opened the door to my life. I'm just gonna do one more song. We're all gonna be like, this was the week. Remember the week Rebecca cried all over songs from the Chrysalis 15? Speaking of ghosts, I've been doing a lot of sort of memoir-y writing and writing a lot about Ireland. You've noticed it's crept into my show again. It's a place that haunts me, has always haunted me. A lot of my ghosts live there, both memories and actual ghosts, I think, from past lives. Anywho, big love affair many years ago, hard to get over, took place in Ireland, yada yada. It's over now, it's fine. But I went back with a friend a couple years ago and visited some of the old places, and it was like a whole thing. And we, in case you haven't heard me tell the story, we met a couple who was very much in love and on a great date, and we spent a couple hours with them playing songs and hanging out. And by the time I left, I had sort of felt like I had passed the torch of like my love affair in Ireland over to some new people, and I went home and wrote a song about it and didn't really know that that's what it was about really until this week. And that was cool. And so it's like a song of hope and starting afresh and also ghosts. Anyway, my name's Rebecca. Thank you for listening. This song is on the album The Magician's Daughter, which you can get on Bandcamp and Spotify. There are two versions. Anywho, it goes like this. He was a ferryman. She was a teacher's aide. I think that's what they said after my serenade. Their love was helium, the brightest thing in the room. As I was coming down,
I asked him how he knew. He said, she's the most alarming thing I know. She is a thing that's planned. She can carry me till I may borrow wings and go over the kestrel strand. Mind what you say, Roisin. Oh, never mind him now. He'll play his songs for you after another round. She was a rocket's tail, lit up on Dave and wine. Said we just met last month, didn't know what I'd find. But he's the most alarming thing I know. He is a thing that's planned. He can carry me till I may borrow wings and go over the kestrel strand.
Above the bar, spilled on the cobblestone, sang till my throat was sore, and then I left alone. Can't seem to shake them off, and it's been a month by now. Probably wouldn't though, even if I knew. I may borrow wings and go over the kestrel strand. Over the kestrel strand. Over the kestrel.
You guys, thank you so much for listening. The tip jar, should you wish to put anything in it, is at Venmo Rebecca-Hart-5 or PayPal Rebecca@RebeccaHart.net. The mailing list is at RebeccaHart.net. Iron John, the podcast version, is up on my page and I will send it to you. We're really proud of it. We hope you can see it on stage someday. And also there is a video version of the Kestrel Strand that I made with the whole band that's on my YouTube channel, which I believe is RAH New York for some reason. Anyway, thank you so much for being here. Happy July, happy 4th, happy my birthday. See you next week.